Quick, name a search engine off the top of your head. You probably said Google, right? Yeah, Google is easily the most popular search engine in the world, and it has been for years. But don't discount the power of Bing. Believe it or not, plenty of people do use Bing. About 100 million a day, actually. So you should consider running ad campaigns in Microsoft Ads, Microsoft being the company behind Bing and a number of other properties. Microsoft Ads is to Bing what Google Ads is to Google. You can create ads for your products and services and target them to specific keywords, audiences, and regions. In this video, I'm going to walk you through some steps that you can take to build an ad campaign in Microsoft Ads. Before we go on, here's your reminder to subscribe to our channel for marketing insights that'll help you grow your business. Now, the first step, of course, is to create a Microsoft Ads account if you don't already have one. Once that's done, log in and click on the blue Create button that'll be there on your home dashboard. That'll take you to a screen where you can choose the goal of your campaign. You'll have options like brand awareness, conversion, leads, and more. Click on the goal that is closest to what you want, or if you don't know yet, just click Skip. If you choose a specific goal like generate leads, Microsoft will limit your campaign types in the next step to those that will best accomplish your goals. If you choose to skip your goal selection, you have a bunch of types to choose from. For consistency, let's say that you skipped your initial goal selection and then choose a search campaign, which means that your ad will show up in the Bing search results. Choose the right ad type and keep going. You can do it. And this is where we get to the screen where you start seeing the details of your campaign. Start off by giving your campaign a unique name so that it's easy to reference for later, and then set your daily budget. As for what your budget should be, well, that's a whole nother conversation, but whatever you decide, you can set it here. Keep in mind that you can always come back and change this later. Then you're gonna go down and choose locations to target or exclude. You can be really general with this, like targeting whole countries, or you can be really specific, like targeting individual cities. Then tell Bing whether your location applies to people actually in that area or people researching that area. Pretty neat specification, if I do say so myself. Okay, next up, you're gonna choose the languages you wanna target. Maybe your campaign is intended to target people in, say, the Netherlands. In that case, you'd wanna select Dutch. Or maybe if you wanna choose both Dutch and English. It all depends on the audience you're trying to reach. Once that's done and you've checked all the boxes that you need to, hit the save and go to the next step. On we go to ad group creation. You can create either standard ad groups or dynamic ones. A standard ad group will require more creative input from you, while a dynamic ad group will create ads automatically based on your website content. You generally have more control over your messaging when using a standard ad group, but there are pros and cons of each. We'll focus on creating a standard ad group for the rest of this tutorial. Ad groups are made up of two things, the ads themselves and the targeting. That's why after you plug in your website URL and give your ad group a name, the next thing you'll do is start listing the keywords you want to target with this ad group. On the right-hand side of the screen, you'll see a box that gives you keyword suggestions. You can use those suggestions, or you can go to a different keyword tool like SEO.com to generate ideas. Either way, you can put the keywords you want to target in the box on the left, separating them with commas. Now, when you put in those keywords, you can actually format them differently depending on how you want Microsoft to target them. If you only want your ads to show up for those exact terms, which is called exact match, then put brackets around them. To target keywords that are very similar, which is called phrase match, you can put quotation marks around them. And if you do neither of those, Microsoft Ads will default to broad match, where it targets any terms at all related to those keywords. Anyway, that's how you create an ad group. But you don't have to stop at just one. By segmenting your campaigns that way, you can make each ad group more specific. Once you're done creating ad groups, though, you can go ahead and click save and go to the next step. Now that you've chosen your keywords, the next step is to create your actual ads. To do that, just click the Create Ad button next to your ad group, which will open up the ad editor. You'll want to go through and fill out the information in this editor, starting with the type of ad you want. In most cases, you'll probably choose a responsive search ad, which has multiple headlines and descriptions that it rotates between based on who's viewing the ad. Then, under Final URL, you'll want to put the URL of the landing page that this ad will link to. Next, write your actual ad copy. Start by coming up with some different headlines for your ads, and then do the same thing with descriptions. Microsoft Ads will recommend some headlines and descriptions to you, but they're not always relevant. proceed with caution, or at least edit the AI suggestions. After you do all of that, you'll be able to see a preview of your ad in the dialog box. If anything about it doesn't look how you want it to, go up and fix it. When you're satisfied with your ad, you can click Save. Once you're done creating your ads, you have the option to set up some ad extensions. I say option, but they're really something that you should consider using. Ad extensions can help your ads stand out in the search results. If you're not sure what ad extensions are, they're basically extra information that appears beneath your ad. They might show information like your phone number, prices, or links to other pages on your site. You can add whatever extensions you want, and then you'll want to go ahead and click Save and go to the next step. That takes you to the final step in this process, setting your budgets and bids. Your daily budget should already be set from earlier, but below that, you'll need to fill out some other information, starting with your bid strategy. There are plenty of options to choose from in the drop-down menu, so just take the time to read them and figure out which one is going to be best for your business. Depending on what you choose, you may be prompted to do different things. For example, some options will prompt you to set a maximum cost per click, while others will let you outline your target return on investment. It just depends on how you want to handle it. At that point, unless you want to mess with any advanced campaign settings, you can click the Save, and just like that, you've created your first ad campaign in Microsoft Ads. When your ads are up and running, you can start to monitor their progress right there on the home dashboard. From there, it's a process of rinse and repeat. You can create as many different ad campaigns as you want and track the results through Microsoft Ads, editing and re-optimizing your ads based on what you see. Other than that, it's just a matter of waiting for leads and conversions to start rolling in. Well, there you have it. That's your guide on how to use Microsoft Ads to create and launch paid ad campaigns. If you're interested in learning more about digital marketing and advertising, be sure to subscribe to our channel and check out some other helpful videos. In the meantime, thank you so much for watching and good luck on your campaigns. See you next time.